The Hamina-class of the Finnish Navy is the most capable missile boat of today. These multi-role vessels can conduct anti-surface, anti-submarine, and anti-air warfare missions effectively. Designed according to the specific needs of Finland, they differ significantly from many of their counterparts in the world. As the weapon detective, we are investigating the Hamina-class, the defender of the Finnish coasts. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel before we start, and give us a thumbs up if you like our video. To be notified of our new video, please click the bell button. Also, you can now click the join button to support our channel. In terms of its capabilities, the Hamina-class is a miniaturized corvette rather than a missile boat. It is one of the best littoral warfare vessels. The Hamina-class is the latest representative of the Finnish fast attack craft design tradition. To better understand this boat, let's take a look at the history of this tradition. After the Second World War, the Western policymakers had seen the geopolitical importance of this country, but their countries were war-weary. So, Helsinki realized that it could not trust the Western support in a possible Soviet invasion. On the other hand, the stubborn and skillful Finnish troops had allowed only one previous victory to the mighty Red Army in the Winter War. So, Stalin did not want to repeat this humiliating experience. Besides, a neutral Helsinki with good relations with the Soviet Union was a preferable option for Moscow. Thus, Finland would turn into a buffer zone with the West, and many Soviet troops could be redeployed from the Leningrad military district to Central Europe. Keeping Finland as a neutral country was the best solution for both sides. The 1947 Paris peace treaties limited the Finnish Navy to a fleet of no more than 10,000 tons and 4,500 men. Also, this naval force would not have offensive weapons such as torpedoes, submarines, mines, and missiles. To keep the balance, in the beginning, Finland bought vessels from both the Western and Eastern blocs. After a while, it began to design and build some naval ships domestically. Helsinki managed to convince both sides of its neutrality. In the 1960s, the Finnish Navy was allowed to have missiles and mines. In 1968, Finland initially laid down Isku as a training vessel. She was commissioned 2 years later. Isku had four P-15 Termit anti-ship missiles, whose NATO reporting name is SSN-2 Styx. After trials, the Finnish Navy decided to acquire the Asa-2-class missile boats from the USSR. Four vessels, which had been equipped with locally developed electronics, were commissioned between 1974 and 1975. Initially, Finland had planned to procure five additional Asa-2s, defined as Tuuli-class in this country. But in 1976, Helsinki decided to design and build indigenous missile boats. So Finland ordered four Helsinki-class missile boats in 1978. Four vessels of this class were commissioned between 1981 and 1986. Different from the Tuuli-class, which had P-15 missiles, the Helsinki-class was equipped with the RBS-15 missiles. By using the experience from these boats, Finland began to work on the Rauma-class in 1987. These new vessels would be equipped with the water jet propulsion system, which provides good maneuverability and can operate in very shallow waters. Also, they would be designed to reduce their magnetic, thermal, radar, and acoustic signatures. With the Rauma class, the Finnish shipyards gained the capability of designing and building modern missile boats. Four vessels of this class were commissioned between 1990 and 1992. As the next step, the Finnish Navy initiated the Squadron 2000 program. Initially, Finland considered commissioning two Hamina-class vessels and four Tuuli-class hovercrafts. After a while, the Finnish Navy abandoned the building program of the Tuuli-class hovercraft, which would have the Umkhonto air defense missile. So, it increased the number of the Hamina-class to four. Now, these boats would be equipped with the Umkhontos. The first vessel of this class, FNS Hamina, was commissioned in 1998. Until 2006, the Finnish Navy commissioned three other Hamina-class boats. All of them were built by Aika Yards Oy. The Hamina-class has a stealth design. The hull is made of aluminum, and the superstructure is carbon fiber reinforced composite. Using extensive composite materials also helped reduce the displacement of the boat. The metal parts are coated with radar absorbing material. To further reduce radar cross-section, the missiles are positioned inside the boat. Except for the bridge, there are no windows on the vessel and there are conductive ceilings on the door and hatches to prevent electromagnetic leakage. The exhaust gas of the propulsion system can be directed either below the surface to minimize thermal signature or above the surface to reduce acoustic signature. The water jets of the Hamina class, which provides good maneuverability and can operate in very shallow waters, also reduce the acoustic and electromagnetic signature. To further reduce the noise level, the main machinery is placed onto resilient mountings. The Hamina class can be operated in the CBRN environment. According to the official data of the Finnish Navy, the complement of the Hamina class is 27 person. The boat has a length of 51 meters, a beam of 8 meters, and a draught of 2 meters. Its fully loaded displacement is 250 tons. The propulsion system of the vessel consists of two 3,750 horsepower MTU-16V 538 TB93 diesel engines and two Kamewa 90S2 water jets. Its maximum speed is 30 knots. The range is 925 kilometers. The Hamina class has 4 RBS-15 anti-ship missiles, 8 Umkhonto air defense missiles, 1 57mm SAK Mark III gun, and two 12.7mm NCV machine guns. It can be equipped with depth charges and it can lay sea mines. Now, the Hamina class boats are being modernized by Patria. We will mention the changes one by one when we introduce the electronics and weapon systems. The C-band TRS-3D phased array surveillance radar of the Hamina class has a range of up to 200 kilometers. It can track 750 targets. This radar can also perform the weapon control function at a range of 21 kilometers. Yet, the weapon systems are controlled by the Ku-band Seros 200 radar and optronic tracking fire control director. The TRS-3Ds and Seros 200s of the vessels are now being updated within the ongoing modernization works. Also, the Atlas ANCS 2000 combat management system of the Hamina class is being replaced with the Saab 9LV combat management system. The Hamina class can perform anti-submarine warfare missions in shallow waters thanks to the Toadfish high-frequency active sonar and the Sonac PTA low-frequency towed sonar. The Kongsberg ST-2400 is replacing the Sonac PTA towed sonar. These boats are equipped with the multi-ammunition soft kill system, shortly MASS, for self-defense system. The MASS can protect the vessel from anti-ship missile attacks by launching decoys that operate in all relevant wavelengths of the electromagnetic spectrum, such as ultraviolet, electro-optical, laser, infrared, and radar. The Hamina class were originally equipped with the RBS-15 Mark II anti-ship missiles, which was defined as MTU-85 by the Finnish Navy. The RBS-15 Mark II has an advanced guidance system which allows radar seeker to be used effectively even when the missile conducts 8G evasive maneuvers. This version has a composite fuselage which reduces the radar and infrared signature of the missile. The missile, which has a 200 kg high explosive blast and pre-fragmented warhead, can reach a range of 150 kilometers. The RBS-15 Mark IIs of the Hamina class are being replaced with the Gabriel 5 missiles, which has an advanced active multispectral seeker designed for cluttered littoral environments. Its range is more than 200 kilometers. Thanks to its GPS and INS navigation systems, the Gabriel 5 can be used against land targets. The Umkhonto-IR air defense missile, which is designated as ITO 2004 by the Finnish Navy, can engage 8 targets simultaneously at a range of 14 kilometers. It has a maximum speed of Mach 2.2 and an effective altitude of 8,000 meters. The infrared guided missile, which has a 23 kilogram warhead, can perform 40G maneuvers. Initially, the Finnish Navy had planned equipping the Hamina class boats with a 40 millimeter gun. But later, these vessels were fitted with a 57mm SAK Mark III gun. This gun has a rate of fire of 200 rounds per minute and a maximum effective range of 17,000 meters. However, the current modernization program has caused some extra weight. To balance this weight, the Finnish Navy decided to replace the SAK Mark III's on these vessels with the lighter 40mm Mark IV guns. This gun, with a reaction time less than 0.5 seconds, can fire the 3P programmable airburst munitions. Also, the manually operated 12.7mm machine guns of the Hamina class are being replaced with the track fire remote control weapon station of Saab. In 2018, the restriction for the use of torpedoes was lifted for the Finnish Navy. So Finland decided to equip its Hamina class boats with a Swedish-made anti-submarine warfare torpedoes. The modernized Hamina class vessel, FNS Tornio, was delivered to the Finnish Navy in 2020. Why are the small missile boats so important for the Finnish Navy? Finland is a country with a small population in a vast area. The Finnish Defense Forces can defend the national sovereignty against a big enemy by using an asymmetric approach. A big surface combatant needs a huge crew. Due to its big draft, it cannot be operated in shallow waters easily. A frigate or destroyer is big, which means it is a big target. Also, it is expensive. A stealth missile boat can be operated by a small crew. The small surface combatant is a difficult target to detect and hit. Besides its low radar cross-section, it can hide behind the islets and rocks. A missile boat carries the same anti-ship missiles as the big surface combatants, so its offensive capability is the same. A country can have a large number of missile boats with the same money that they would have to spend on a single frigate or destroyer. Thus, it can defend a larger area. Many of the missile boats in the world do not have anti-submarine warfare capability. But the Hamina class can also hunt the submarines. These boats can blockade the sea routes of an amphibious assault force or naval strike force by laying sea mines. Due to its limited human resource, Finland cannot win a possible war against a country with a huge army. During the 1939 Winter War, brave and skillful Finnish troops had become a nightmare for the Soviet army. But in the end, Finland, which didn't receive sufficient foreign support, had to accept the defeat. In a possible war, Finland cannot dominate the surrounding sea by itself against a big navy for a long time, but it can gain time for foreign support or daunt its enemy. The best instrument of this tactic is the missile boats. The biggest enemy of the missile boats is the aircraft and helicopters. But different from many counterparts in the world, the Hamina class can also fight against them. Supported by coast artillery and missile batteries, as well as the Finnish Air Force, these small surface combatants are the biggest deterrent elements of the Finnish Navy. Of course, compared to the bigger surface combatants, the small size of the Hamina class also brings some disadvantages like range and endurance. But please don't forget that this boat was designed for defensive purposes. The Finnish Navy does not plan to attack or blockade a country far away by using its Hamina class boats. Different jobs require different vessels. In the near future, Finland will commission the Pohjanmaa class corvettes to support multinational overseas operations. The Hamina class is stealth. It can fight against ships, aircraft, and submarines. Thanks to the new Gabriel 5 missiles, these boats can also conduct land attacks. They are the naval systems which efficiently answer Finland's defensive requirements. With these features, the Hamina class is currently one of the best missile boats in the world. Thanks for watching our video. And please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and give us a thumbs up if you liked our video. To be notified of our new videos, please click the bell button. Also, you can now click the join button to support our channel.